This is a young kid that's excited, just wants a chance to play. And he talked about kind of the difference between playing in St. Louis, where they were a veteran-laden team and you couldn't make a whole lot of mistakes. Otherwise, you were got the quick hook. Whereas in Buffalo, maybe there's a little longer leash for a guy like Tage Thompson.
You know, players look at where they look at their circumstances different at different stages of their career. Tage Thompson is at a stage where he's trying to establish himself as an everyday, dependable, and impactful NHLer. So this presents an opportunity transferring from St. Louis, where the margin of error was razor thin for Tage Thompson. One mistake, you're missing some ice time. I think he's going to get a much longer leash in Buffalo under Phil Housley. And I think this is a situation where he's going to be given the kind of responsibility to develop as an NHLer and have an impact and realize his full potential. Obviously, a potential that he feels is there and he's going to be able to employ once a member of the Buffalo Sabres.
And you mentioned it before. I mean, they're in the most difficult division in the National Hockey League. So when you're going out there every night, you can't experiment. You can't be used in experimental ways if you're Tage Thompson. Right. And that's no knock to Mike Yeo and coaching staff, because you're playing against some of the best teams in the National Hockey League on a nightly basis. So what this gives him now, Tage Thompson up there in Buffalo, is now they get to kind of smoke out what kind of player is he. He's former first-round pick in 2016. So there's a high ceiling there. And what is he? Where are some areas that his game can still develop, and where's his ceiling at? Those are great things to find out. Sometimes it's hard when you're doing that. You know, I came in the league in a New Jersey Devils organization that was one of the best teams in the league. So when you are given sheltered minutes, you've got to kind of, you know, it's tough. And so this is a breath of fresh air for Tage Thompson. He's going to get plenty of opportunity. But now here's the tough part. You got to come through and show you can do it.
Exactly. Right.
I asked you yesterday, I said, what is this Buffalo Sabres team? And that was while Ryan O'Reilly was still a part of it, getting in a guy like Carter Hutton as the goaltender for the next couple of years. You have Jack Eichel. You just draft Rasmus Dahlin, number one overall. What is this team like next year without Ryan O'Reilly now in the mix?
It's, you know, now this is starting to look more and more like Jason Botterill's team. And Ryan O'Reilly, I'm a huge Ryan O'Reilly fan. I used to skate with him when he played in the OHL in Erie. Complete player. He can do a little bit of everything and at a high level. But that was the old regime. Remember, they brought in the Evander Kane. They brought in, but now Jason Botterill's been able to get rid of those players, and look what he's been able to do in the process, is picking up some first-round picks. You've got Patrick Berglund and Vladimir Sobotka, which I like those two players because I think that it allows them to, they need to change the culture. Those guys know how to play structured hockey. They've done it their whole careers. You know what? When you look at some of the stuff that they're bringing back into Buffalo, the future's bright there.
Yeah, and, you know, we're fond of saying anytime we analyze a trade, win-win. Both teams got something they wanted. I think this is more along the lines of home run. I mean, St. Louis gets that top two center. They get that impactful player. Sabres, by contrast, are in a much different spot. This is a club that's looking to just build credibility, a club that can compete with the rest of the clubs in the NHL. And I think they do that adding players through the middle portion, the depth of their roster, like Sabotka. Like Berglund, Tage Thompson will be given a healthy level of responsibility. So this will be an interesting club to watch, having shored up the forward core and Carter Hutton as well within the pipes. It'll be interesting to see how this club fares.
Loading up the picks, too. Three first-rounders next year, that draft 2019 in Vancouver. So
they got
a load of currency.
They're coming.
They're coming. The Buffalo Sabres, keep your eye on them.